In other news, Tuvalu's Foreign Minister Simon Kofe has announced the country is moving to the Metaverse. He told COP27 attendees it was time to replicate the island nation's landscape digitally so it can its people can maintain their culture despite the impacts of climate change. Tuvalu is threatened by rising sea levels and is likely to be underwater within this century.
And the Foreign Minister, Simon Kofe, joins us now. Minister, we'll get to some of the details about this in a second, but how do you feel about the fact that you've had to resort to this?
Well, it is quite frustrating when, you know, we keep advocating for countries to take stronger climate action. And, you know, every year we come back, we fall short. So I guess there's a bit of frustration in that. But for us, we want to focus as well on what we can do as a country and deliver for our people. And so our efforts are focused on that at the moment.
You started by recreating one island digitally. Why have you chosen this particular island to start with?
Well, this is one of the islets on the capital of Tuvalu, Funafuti. And I chose this island because it demonstrates quite clearly the impacts of the erosion. The process by which these islands actually disappear is that you see the vegetation start to die off, not just from the coast, but the water also seeps through the ground, which then kills the vegetation. And then eventually, you know, the island becomes a sandbank and it'll be washed away after some time. And so I chose this island because it's probably one of the first that will go underwater.
This is also about maintaining sovereignty as well, isn't it?
That's correct. That's something that we've been working on for a couple of years now. In our foreign policy, we insisting that any country that wants to establish ties with Tuvalu, diplomatic ties, that they have to recognize the legal proposition that Tuvalu can continue to exist as a state, even if we lose our physical territory in the future, and also recognition of our claims to our maritime zones. So we have about seven countries that have already recognized that. We signed joint communiques with those countries, and we will continue to do that because I think the more countries recognize these principles, then it contributes to the development of new customary international law.
Minister Kofe, thank you so much for speaking to us tonight.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.